Oh, Bran. With so many characters throughout the show, it's kinda hard to pick favorites, but here we go. Between the Targaryens, the Lannisters, and the Starks, let's take a closer look and dive into the character arcs. Arya went from a troublemaking girl to a badass assassin to the savior of the world, and she still wields the power of the camouflage, but we never really see it, so it's bon voyage. Sansa's got the Stark arc that we actually dig. She was so naive when she was a little kid, but now she's grown into the queen of the north. She learned from Littlefinger and Cersei, of course. And then we got Jon Snow, he was so damn cool, a true leader and a king and a real good dude. And when I say this, my intention is not to be rude, but now that he's killed Dany, he is of no use. Dany went from young girl to mother of dragons, then the breaker of chains, and the whip stopped cracking. She was all we hoped for, so it seemed. Turned out this dragon was the Mad Queen. When we first met Cersei, she was a cunning ruler, but the loss of her children made her stunningly crueler. This was all shaping up to the ultimate villain, but for the bulk of last season, she was basically chilling. Books, whores, and wine with Tyrion's thing. Then he gets a shot at being the Hand of the King. For most of the show, there was nobody wiser, but he ends up becoming just a spineless advisor. And then our little dude Bran always wanted to climb, became the three-eyed raven with the power of time. But that's not all, because here's the thing, how the heck did Bran the Broken become the king? But this is a show that we'll never forget. Let's kick back, chill, and reminisce on Game of Thrones and the greatest hits. Bran, can you help us out with this?
Oh, I'm sorry. Your Grace, can you help us out with this?
Jamie gives a little shove, John shows a little love. Tyrion lays down a hand, Summer saves his own a brand. Cereo says not today, Nettie's head gets thrown away. Danny is a little older, dragon resting on her shoulder. Melisandre kills Renly and Danny sets her dragons free. Wildfire on the ocean, battle rage and much commotion. These two take a tubby break, John and Egret in a cave. Ramsay has a special dinner, bear fight doesn't have a winner. Danny steps up to command, same old Tarly makes a stand. They continue rumor spreading, everyone dies at the wedding. Hound fighting for some chicken, Dario is on a mission. Jamie gives his sword away, he dies on his wedding day. These two simply can't agree, Tyrion gives quite a speech. Skeletons come from below, the children say that we must go. The Viper's head gets torn apart, he gets shot right through his heart. Drogon comes in with the flames, Cersei takes her walk of shame. Hardhome happens, lots of death, Johnny takes his final breath. Melisandre's hella old, John is back and looking cold. Dany burns the temple down, Arya depends on sound. We learn of the Night King's birth, Arryn has been confirmed. Bolton dogs are looking hungry, she crosses the narrow sea. Bastard fight, he holds the door, the set blows up straight on the floor. Arya has a massacre, Olenna says that he was hurt. Littlefinger's life expires, Danny hits him with the fire. John means stroking vengeance, saves John, watch out for Viserion. Now we're fully up to date, God, the show is friggin' great.
The knee has been bended, and our watch is ended. We have to thank you, Game of Thrones.
Thanks for watching.